Okay, we'll start today's lecture with what we finished last week. Now, let's come back and make a small revision for the inverter and how the inverter works. Usually we said, let me summarize these things. If you have a bridge inverter like this, four switches, these four switches has like a mechanism to work. Okay, this mechanism is no single bridge, no two transistor in a single bridge should work together. Okay, like switch one and two here must be complementary to each other, which means when the switch one is on conducting, switch two must be off, must be open circuit all the time. If switch two is conducting, switch one must be off all the time. Why? Because if both are conducting, this will make short circuit to the power supply. Okay, so a general rule for inverters, switch one and two must be complementary to each other. Likewise, switch 3 and 4 must be complementary to each other. Number 2, switch 1 and 4 must work together at the same time. Okay, when switch 1 is conducting, switch 2, switch 4 must be conducting. When switch 3 is conducting, switch 2 must be conducting. So we make sure that these two switches work together and these two switches may, work together. So this is the case here for the output voltage. Now, if the current is in phase with the voltage, so the current will be flowing within the transistors. If the current is negative, so the negative current will flow in the diode. The same thing will happen for the negative side. If both negatives, so the current, the negative current will be flowing where? Will be flowing in the transistors. If we have positive current, let's say like that, the positive current will be flowing in the diode. We said, of course, now we were able to convert the voltage output from DC, from input DC to AC output, but that this AC is square wave. The problem of this square wave is just have a lot of harmonics, because we know that the square wave is what? The square wave is a combination of sine waves and cosine waves with different amplitude, right? So if you think about this square wave, we cannot just use this square wave and inject it to the grid or inject it, give it to like a load. This will make a lot of destruction, maybe make damage a lot of devices. So it's not a good idea, or even it's not allowed to use a sine wave or an AC waveform with loads of harmonics. We need to minimize this harmonics. Now, the way that we can modify this current and make it closer to the sine wave is that we don't generate a square wave on the output. We try to chop this square wave to smaller square waves. Okay, so this is the main idea. Here we have, instead of using S1 and S4 conducting all the time in the positive side, no. We said, okay, we want to conduct them at a certain period, then off, make them off at another certain period. So what we do actually is we make switch 1 and 4 on at this point, okay? And here in the zero voltage, we make switch 1 and switch 3 on. Instead of switch 1 and switch 4, we disconnect switch 4 and connect switch 3. But the conduction will be through switch 1 and diode 3. So the current will be circulating within switch 1 and diode 3, but the output has zero voltage. Okay, when the output has zero voltage, then here at that point we make sure that our voltage is like changing from VDC 0, VDC 0, VDC 0. Same thing will happen on the negative side. We conduct switch 3 and switch 2, but also we make sure that the current is circulating within switch 2 and diode 4, okay, on the negative side. Now, if you look at the current here, you will find the current will be something like this. The current will be increasing when the output is positive. Then when we disconnect this one, you'll find it decreasing, right? Increasing, decreasing, increasing, decreasing, and so on. And the sine wave, the output current waveform, it will look like the sine wave. How can we make it sine wave? We just add small filter, like LC filter, for example, or LCL filter, and you'll find this waveform looks like sine wave, no problems. And at that point, we can inject this waveform to our grid. you'll find that here we need a modulation technique, so not all the time we'll use like on and off. We have some also improved mechanisms to do this. General way is how to generate this pulse width modulated signal to be sent to the switches. We compare a triangular wave or the carrier wave with a reference wave. In the past, we compare it with for the DC, let's say for the DC DC-DC converters, we compare it with a DC with just a straight line reference signal. Now the reference signal can be sine wave, okay, to make it like closer to the sine wave and to try to play with the width of this PWM. We need to not only compare it with a straight reference signal or the control signal. We need to compare this triangular wave with a sine wave, okay, with a sine wave. Now let's go to the modulation techniques, like how can we make this one. Now as we said, we compare the sine wave here with a triangular wave, or maybe you can use a sawtooth wave. And one of the techniques is what we call the bipolar switching. The bipolar switchings make sure that your output is changing from plus VDC to minus VDC, and that's why we call it bipolar, okay, from plus VDC to minus VDC. We just compare the sine wave with the triangular wave, and we say in the comparison, if the sine wave, if this sine wave, the green one here, is larger than the triangular wave, then the output must be plus VDC. If the sine wave is less than the triangular wave, then the output must be minus VDC. How to do this? When the sine wave is greater than the triangular wave, so we will get this signal. So we'll take this signal and say, please make switch 1 and switch 2 on. When the sine wave is larger than the triangular wave, switch 1 and switch 2 are conducting. When the sine wave smaller than triangular wave, I will make the opposite, which is switch 3 and switch 4, I'll make them on. Now of course, when switch 1 and switch 2 are on, what happened to switch 3 and switch 4? They must be off. And here likewise, same thing, switch 1 and switch 2 are off. So this is what we call bipolar switching. When we apply this signal to switch 1, switch 2, switch 3, and switch 4, you'll find the output here will be either VDC or minus VDC. That is very simple, the simplest modulation technique. But the problem here for this modulation technique is that the voltage is changing from VDC to minus VDC. And here, when you apply a filter for this waveform on the output, you'll find that you need a large filter to make sure that your sine wave is a pure sine wave. So here is signals. This is signals comparing and going to the switches. And here's waveform, the output, plus 200, minus 200. For this plus 200, minus 200, we need a large filter to make this waveform looks like the sine wave, okay? Now, is there any other modulation techniques? Of course, there are many modulation techniques. One of the modulation techniques is what we call the unipolar switching or unipolar modulation. Let's look at the unipolar modulation. What we do in the unipolar modulation? We compare the triangular wave with a sine wave, and also we compare the same triangular wave with minus sine wave. So here we have two comparisons. The first one with sine wave, the second comparison will be with minus sine wave. Okay, so what we do actually here is, when the sine wave is larger than the triangular wave, what we do, switch 1 is on. And when minus sine wave is less than the triangular wave, we make switch 2 on. And the same switch will be on, like the same switch on the leg will be off, of course. Like when the switch 1 is on, the other switch on the same leg will be off. Now, when minus sine wave is larger than the triangular wave, this will be, it would make switch 3 is on. And when the positive sine wave is less than the triangular wave, this will make switch 4 to be on. So here we'll control switch by switch. We'll compare sine wave with the triangular wave. you'll get VA, and you'll send this signal when the sine wave is larger than the triangular wave, you'll send it to switch number one. At the same time, you'll compare the negative sine wave with triangular wave and send it to switch two. So one will work this way and the other will work in this way. What is the benefit of this one? You'll find that VA, the VA and VB looks like this, and VAB will be always positive, will not jump from plus to minus, okay? Because you compare now two signals, one with the sine wave and the other one with the minus sine wave. Look at this point here, for example. This zero, it's always zero. Minus zero, it will be zero. This is a positive VDC. Minus zero, it will be VDC. Or minus VDC, it will be how much? It will be zero. Now look at here, for example. The zero side is wider than the zero side here. Zero minus VDC, it will be minus VDC. Here, VDC minus VDC, it will be zero, and so on. So on the output, VAB, this will be changing from VDC to minus VDC. But not at the same time. This will be VDC on the positive cycle, and this will be minus VDC on the negative cycle. Now what I suggest you to do, because these modulation techniques sometimes is not straightforward, you just need to compare each one of them and see the mechanism exactly. And then you can do this on MATLAB or on Plex. You just make a comparison between sine wave and the triangular wave and generate your own pulse. Now, do we have any other modulation technique? Of course, we have another unipolar. The switches will not be operating all the time. So the other way is to do like this. We compare the sine wave, the positive sine wave, with the triangular wave, and we generate the same waveform here for VA, let's say. So this at high frequency. The other one will be at low frequency. This one at 1 over, this one at the switching frequency, and this one at the 1 over T, like the 50 Hertz frequency. You will generate the same waveform, but this waveform will be only depends on the either VA or VB. How to do this? When the sine wave is larger than the triangular wave, we can say that switch one is on, but this one is high frequency, in the switching frequency. And when the sine wave is smaller than the triangular wave, we can say switch four is on, and this one also at high frequency. Now, the other comparison, this sine wave, do you think we should compare it with what? With the triangular wave or something else? How can we generate this one? This clearly is what? A sine wave compared with a straight line, right? So we say at this point, V sine is larger than zero. If the sine wave larger than zero, so we say the switch 2 is on, and when the sine wave is less than 0, switch 3 is on. And this, of course, at low frequency, which is the 50 Hz, 50, 60 Hz. And when you subtract this one, VA minus VB, you'll find that this portion is always minus 0. You'll get the same portion here, no problems. And this portion here, it will be minus VDC, so it will be as if it's shifted, okay? It will be shifted from zero to minus VDC. Here also a unipolar switching technique or unipolar modulation technique. Well, here modulation techniques, you will find a wide range of modulation techniques. It's not only one modulation technique. But the main idea is we compare a triangular wave with a sine wave to operate the switches. If we manage to do that, so no problems, okay? One thing we need to take care about is the relation between this sine wave and the triangular wave, okay? Should we say the sine wave here, the amplitude of the sine wave must be larger than the triangular wave, or the amplitude of the sine wave must be less than the triangular wave, okay? This relation between the sine wave amplitude and the triangular wave amplitude is what we call the amplitude modulation index. And also we can use this relation to increase the output voltage of the inverter. So for example, if we decrease the modulation index, we make sure that the sine wave is much smaller than the triangular wave amplitude, you'll find that the output voltage will be less. So you can control with the output voltage, either increase or decrease. Okay, so the modulation index, we can say this is MA. This is the amplitude because we compare the amplitude together, the amplitude of the trigger wave with the amplitude of the sine wave. The amplitude modulation index is equal to how much? The maximum of the sine wave over the maximum of the triangular wave. By this, we can calculate the modulation index. If the modulation index is 1, which means what? We have the same amplitude for both sine wave and triangular wave, and then you get like perfect signal. Usually, the modulation index is less than 1. We usually put it 0.8, 0.9. So if the modulation index is less than or equal 1, so the amplitude of the fundamental frequency of the output voltage is linearly proportional to the MA. So we can say that V out is equal to MA times VDC. So if we increase this one or decrease this one, we can change the output voltage. If MA is greater than 1, the amplitude of the output increases with MA, but not linearly. And also we have some problem like the harmonics will be increased. They are not difficult. We just need to think about how to operate the switches and make them on or off. Okay. Tell me, do you have any question for this or not?